This video is a continuation of our previous discussion about jet engines. In the last video, we explained how jet engine components, such as the combustion chamber, turbine blades, and nozzle, are able to withstand extremely high temperatures without melting. This is made possible by a cooling system that uses compressed air to form a protective layer, preventing direct contact between the components and the hot gases. However, we haven't yet discussed the materials used to manufacture these components. In this video, we will focus specifically on the materials used to make gas turbine blades, the parts that are directly exposed to the intense heat of combustion, and how they are manufactured. Jet engine turbine blades are not made from steel, but from special nickel-based alloys known as superalloys. One commonly used superalloy is Nimonic, a product of Special Metals Corporation. Nimonic is composed of approximately 54% nickel, 20% chromium, and other elements such as aluminum and titanium. Another well-known superalloy is Inconel, also nickel and chromium-based, but with different composition ratios. Although nickel has a lower melting point than steel, these superalloys have the advantage of retaining their strength at extremely high temperatures, even above 1,000 degrees Celsius. Steel, on the other hand, loses its strength significantly under such conditions. In recent developments, ceramic-based materials called ceramic matrix composites are also being used for turbine blades, offering excellent heat resistance along with reduced weight. The manufacturing process of turbine blades depends heavily on their position within the engine. Blades located toward the rear, where temperatures are relatively lower, can be produced using CNC machines because their shapes are simpler and do not include internal cooling channels. However, first-stage turbine blades, which are exposed directly to combustion and include internal cooling passages, are produced using a specialized technique known as investment casting or lost wax casting. This method has been known since ancient times, but has evolved into a highly precise and complex manufacturing process today. The process begins by designing a 3D model of the turbine blade using specialized software that also simulates mechanical stress and thermal loads on the component. Once the design is complete, a metal mold is created, not to cast the blade directly, but to produce a wax pattern of the blade. Inside the wax pattern, a ceramic core is inserted to form the internal cooling channels. The core is made by compressing ceramic powder with a binder, then heating it to harden and strengthen it. Next, molten wax is injected into the mold containing the ceramic core, forming the full wax model of the blade with the core embedded inside. This wax model is then inspected using radiographic and ultrasonic methods to ensure the core is correctly positioned. After that, the wax pattern is repeatedly dipped into a ceramic slurry and coated with ceramic powder to build up a thick ceramic shell. Once dry, the wax inside is removed by heating it in an autoclave, a high-pressure chamber, to prevent cracking of the ceramic shell caused by wax expansion. The empty mold is then inspected again using a special blue dye to detect any cracks or leaks. If the mold passes inspection, it is wrapped in ceramic fiber insulation to prevent the molten metal from cooling too rapidly, which could cause internal cracks. The superalloy metal is then melted under an inert atmosphere or in a vacuum to prevent oxidation. Before pouring, the mold is also preheated to avoid thermal shock due to sudden temperature differences. When poured, the molten metal fills all the cavities within the mold and is allowed to cool gradually using a technique called directed solidification, which causes the metal to solidify from the tip to the base. Once solidified, the ceramic shell is broken off using vibration. The blades are cut from the cluster, and the surfaces are smoothed. However, the ceramic core still remains inside the blade and must be removed. This is done by dissolving the core with a special soda-based solution. After cleaning, the blades are inspected again for any cracks, leaks, or other defects. Very small cooling holes are then drilled using precision techniques such as electrical discharge machining. Some blades are also coated with a thermal barrier coating, a ceramic layer that further protects the surface from extreme heat. A final inspection is carried out to ensure dimensional and weight accuracy. This is critical because turbine blades spin at extremely high speeds, and even a tiny weight imbalance can cause vibrations that could damage the engine. Once all steps are completed and the blades pass all quality tests, the components are ready to be assembled into a gas turbine engine. It's no surprise that a single first-stage turbine blade can cost thousands of dollars, given how complex and precise the manufacturing process is.